The NFL is made up of, well, we don't have the stats with us, but we'll rightly presume 99.9% of guys who were born in America. Of course, your five-year-old kids probably know that already. It's American football for crying out loud. Everyone else plays football, as in soccer, and Canada has the CFL. But hey, there are a handful of non-American-born players who have succeeded in the NFL. I'm Justin Fraction, and today we dive into the 10 best non-American NFL players ever. And we do hope you enjoy this video, and if you do, feel free to click subscribe down below for more cool videos every single day. Number 10, Reuben Mays. Despite being born in Saskatchewan, Mays was named an All-American in 1986 after dominating at Washington State. The New Orleans Saints drafted him 57th overall in 1986, as the Canadian embarked on a decent NFL career. He rushed for 1,353 yards and 8 touchdowns in his rookie year. Mays never got close to those numbers again, though. He finished with 3,483 rushing yards and 23 rushing touchdowns. Obviously not great numbers, but better than just about every other Canadian running back to play in the NFL, if there even is another. Number 9, Sebastian Vollmer. Spätzünder. That's German for late bloomer, because 1. Vollmer was born in Karst, Germany, and 2. Vollmer was 14 years of age when he began to play American football, so that's pretty late. The New England Patriots drafted Vollmer 58th overall in 2009. And the 6'8", 320-pound offensive tackle became a huge protector of Tom Brady. Vollmer's efforts in the 2014 season helped New England win Super Bowl 49. Though he was injured for the 2016 season, Vollmer was technically part of the Patriots' Super Bowl 51 championship team as well. Good call drafting him, Bill Belichick. Number 8, Ezekiel Ansah. Ansah was born in Ghana back in 1989, and we're pretty sure nobody was expecting him to become one of the NFL's premier defensive ends. The Detroit Lions drafted Ansah 5th overall in 2013, and he's delivered big time. Ansah made the Pro Bowl in 2015 after racking up 14.5 sacks and 4 forced fumbles. Through his first 4 seasons, Ansah had 30 sacks and 9 forced fumbles. Who said you should only draft American-born players? Number 7, Osei Umenyora. Umenyora is from Nigeria, and he was born in London, England in 1981. When he was a child, Osei's family moved back to Nigeria. But then he moved to America as a teen and played college football at Troy. The New York Giants drafted the star pass rusher 46th overall in 2003. Umenyora was part of the legendary 2007 Giants pass rush that took down the undefeated Patriots in Super Bowl 42. He added another ring with them in Super Bowl 46. Umenyora, a 2-time Pro Bowler, finished his career with 13 forced fumbles and 75 sacks. Number 6, Sebastian Janikowski. Janikowski was born in Poland, but his dad moved the family to America as he tried to continue his professional soccer career. Though Janikowski didn't play world football, he took up American football as a kicker. The Oakland Raiders drafted Janikowski 17th overall in 2000, and he's been arguably the best kicker of the 21st century. Through the 2016 season, Janikowski booted 414 field goals and made 80.4% of his attempts. Cristiano Ronaldo's lucky he chose football over soccer. Number 5, Temba Haley. Ali was born in a town in Liberia that's home to just over 34,000 people. What are the odds a star NFL player will come out of there? Well, the Kansas City Chiefs went against the odds and drafted him 20th overall in 2006. Ali emerged as one of the top outside linebackers in the NFL shortly thereafter. Through his first 11 seasons, Ali was named to 5 Pro Bowls and had 89.5 sacks, 33 forced fumbles, and 16 interceptions. Now that's overcoming the odds. Number 4, Gary Anderson. Born in South Africa, Anderson had the right genes to be a legendary NFL kicker, since his father was a pro soccer player in England. Anderson actually played soccer and then decided to give kicking a try in American football. The 4-time Pro Bowler busted into the NFL in 1982. Anderson had a perfect season in 1998, until the final minutes of the NFC Championship game. But still, 35 of 35 field goals in the regular season is impressive. Anderson scored 2,434 points, booted 538 field goals, and finished with an 80.1 field goal percentage. He was named to the 1980s and 1990s All-Decade Team. Good call going from soccer to American football, Gary. Number 3, Morten Andersen. Man, this guy just played forever. The Danish-born kicker came to America in 1977 as an exchange student and won a scholarship to kick for Michigan State. Andersen then embarked on a kicking career for the ages. He played in 1982 to 2007 and was named to 7 Pro Bowls, the 80s and 90s All-Decade Team, and he took home 2 Golden Toe Awards. Andersen holds many records among kickers, including 2,544 points scored, 565 made field goals, and 382 games played. Not bad for a guy born in Denmark who had to find a living in America as a youth. Number 2, Leo Nomalini. Born in Tuscany, Italy, Nomolini's family moved to the U.S. when he was an infant. It turned out to be a good move by his parents, because Nomolini was drafted 11th overall by the San Francisco 49ers in 1950. Nomolini then emerged as one of the most dominant tackles ever. He was named to 10 Pro Bowls and the 1950s All-Decade Team. He played with San Fran from 1950 to 1963 and was inducted into the Pro Football Hall of Fame. From Tuscany to Canton, what a journey. And number one, Ernie Stotner. Stotner was born in Germany way back in 1925, but his family opted to move to New York when he was just a little child. He took up American football and played at Boston College before being selected 22nd overall by the Pittsburgh Steelers in 1950. Stotner played his entire 14-year career in the Steel City. He was a 10-time All-Pro, 9-time Pro Bowler, and was named to the 1950s All-Decade Team. The Hall of Famer also won two Super Bowls with the Dallas Cowboys as an assistant coach. His parents made a great choice moving to the land of the free and home of the brave. Who do you think is the greatest non-American NFL player? Join us in the comments section below. If you liked this video and learned a thing or two, clicking the like button helps us out a ton and we appreciate it. If this is your first time coming around to Total Pro Sports though, subscribing is a great idea because we put out videos like this every single day. But as always, thanks for watching and we'll see you guys next time.